FreePBX has been hit with a severe zero-day vulnerability that would allow attackers to gain access and rack up huge phone bills for affected servers and potentially allow them to pivot to other servers behind your firewall. If you have a FreePBX system, you're going to want to take action now to ensure that you're not compromised. And you're also going to want to double check that your system is set up the right way so that you can't be compromised. In this video, I'm first going to show you how you should be configuring your FreePBX so that you avoid this type of vulnerability. Then we're going to talk about how to check if your current system is already compromised. And finally, we're going to talk about mitigation, right? So if you find that you've been hit with the zero day, how can you recover from it? And as always, if you would like Crosstalk to take a look at your system to see if it's been hit, or if you just want to ensure that you're all dialed in with best practices when it comes to security and your configuration, that's our specialty, and we are here to help you if you need help. I should also mention that if you're an existing Crosstalk PBX customer, whether that's hosted or on-premises, you are likely not affected by this zero-day because we never expose the FreePBX admin GUI to the outside world. We only allow access to the admin GUI through VPN or with specifically authorized IP addresses. But of course, we are happy to double check for you to give you some peace of mind. Okay, let's get started. I'll have links to everything that I'm discussing down in the description below, but the latest info can always be found in the FreePBX forum post that's specifically discussing this vulnerability. So this zero day started hitting systems around August 21st, 2025, and Sangoma first announced it 5 days later, and they came out with an Edge module fix for the problem on that same day. The zero-day vulnerability affects FreePBX versions 16 and 17, but if you're on FreePBX version 15 or older, it's probably worth checking your system anyways. And as a side note, FreePBX version 15 is officially end of life with no more security updates as of this coming Monday, September 1st, 2025. So you should really be upgrading your system at this point anyways. And again, contact us here at Crosstalk Solutions if you need any help upgrading. But unfortunately, since the latest and greatest FreePBX version 17 is on a different base operating system, you can't just upgrade in place on the same hardware. You have to build up a new server, install FreePBX, and then restore your configuration. Now, we've been doing this a lot lately here at Crosstalk because of the FreePBX 15 end of life. So contact us if you want us to handle all of that for you. Sangoma did release a security patch for this issue, but keep in mind that their security patch is not going to fix a compromised system. It's simply going to prevent you from getting compromised in the future. So you're still going to want to check to see if your system has been hit. As I said previously, this zero-day vulnerability affects systems that have the FreePBX admin GUI exposed to the internet zone through the FreePBX firewall. So first, let's start by checking your server to see if it's exposed to the internet zone, and then I'm going to show you how to lock that down. Here I have a Crosstalk PBX server. I'm running FreePBX version 16 in the back end here. And the first thing we want to do is go to connectivity and then firewall. And then you want to pull out the side tray here and choose services. And this is where it shows you which services are opened up through which firewall zones. And the one you want in particular here is web management or web management secure. This is the FreePBX admin GUI. Now notice in mine, it's only opened to the local zone and no other firewall zones. That's what you wanna see. If you see internet toggled on, or if you see other toggled on, you're gonna wanna start to dig deeper because those are the systems that are affected by this zero day. Now, if you are only set to local, you can still open up the firewall to specific IPs. Let me show you how to do that next. You go to connectivity firewall, And then you want to click on the Networks tab. And under the Networks tab, this is where you can add your exceptions, right? So basically, you're adding WAN IP addresses that can connect to this server. So for example, this is a hosted system. And so we put in all of our WAN IP addresses so that we can connect to the server, and our WAN IP addresses aren't going to be scrutinized by the firewall, or they're considered trusted by the firewall. The other thing you want to make sure is that under the intrusion detection tab, intrusion detection is status running. That means intrusion detection is turned on. This just helps mitigate people that are trying to, you know, brute force their way into the system. This blocks them from doing that too many times. Okay, now let's talk about how you can check if your FreePBX system has been compromised. Now, there's a great article. I'll have it linked below. This is in Bleeping Computer. And here it shows you all of the things that you need to check for or symptoms of an infected machine. So let's go ahead and run through all of these now. You're going to want to connect to this server with SSH, and the first one says here to search for a missing or modified slash etc slash freepbx.conf configuration file. So we want to do ls-la/etc/freepbx.conf. Now, in my case, what I can see here is I do have a freepbx.conf file, but the last time it was modified was January 12th. 2023. So that means that it has not been changed recently. You would want to, if it says it's been changed since August 21st, 2025, that's a bad sign. The next thing is the presence of var://html.clean.sh shell script. So let's look for that next. Clear, and we can say ls-la/var://html, and then we want to grep for the word clean. And it is not there, so I am all good. The next thing we want to look for is suspicious Apache log entries for modular.php. So again, we can say grep modular.php in var log /access_log*. This is going to check all of our Apache logs. And we can see that I do not have any instances of modular.php, so we are all good there. Next, we want to check for unusual calls to extension 9998 in the asterisk logs as far back as August 21st. So to do that, we're going to say grep 9998, and we're going to search for var log *full*, enter. And again, we didn't find anything, so that's a really good sign. And finally, this vulnerability puts a new user into the database that Asterisk uses in MySQL. So let's go ahead and check to see if that user's there. We can say MySQL-E select username from AMP users *. And what we're seeing here is the only username that I have in that database is admin, or I guess in that table is admin. And if you see one that says AMP user, that's a sign that you've been infected. So that's a system that you're gonna wanna take a closer look at or restore from backup. So that being said, if you do find that your system has been compromised, the best thing that you can do is restore the server from a backup or from a snapshot that was taken prior to August 21st. And then you want to run the patches that are in their blog post over here. You should also comb through your phone bills to see if you see any unusual charges, especially charges out to international numbers. And again, if you need any assistance with any of this, just contact us here at Crosstalk and we will make sure that you're secure. Okay. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.